I have no idea. Look at it from this side. Why is that there? Why is there a lollipop like with sparks around it? Oh, that looks like a bigger house, doesn't it? Let's see, look around here. Any more sparking lollipops? Alright, well that thing is that way, just I don't want to get turned around. Well, this is quite an awkward position. You'd think it would flatten the ground first. Some bags. Continue that way. This is like two stories. Well, yeah, two stories. Here we've got boxes in the way. Wow. Yeah. Pretty sure we're headed the right way. I have my Spirit of the Wind going. Hopefully it lasts us for a while. Okay, these are flowers.
I suppose they may be right. If my concern for the world about me, being greater than my concern for myself, is madness, then yes, I am mad. He continued. We should never want for more than we need, for that is the beginning of the end. The collecting of things beyond our need is, to me, the truer madness. In the endless collecting of things, we become heavy and burdened with possessions. After a time, it is the possessions that possess us.
Yeah, but still, you ate a cricket. Was it a cricket or a grasshopper? You give away fish, well, you trade fish, and you eat crickets. Use crickets for bait, not to eat. Now, I thought, that was funny, I was about to say before that these flowers, I thought were more of the red triangles. But, no, they were flowers, actually. As we've seen.
Consider the fishes, he said. They have no possessions and so can flit about on the waters, light and unburdened, free to swim anywhere.
To catch
if
them.
If they had possessions to carry, they would sink and die. This seemed obvious enough to me. Fish can't carry things anyway. Consider also the story of a king I once knew. I quietly laughed, as if the mad fisher cavorted with kings. I thought this very unlikely.
You could cavort with a mad king. But yeah, fish don't have opposable thumbs, or actually limbs of any sort that we consider to be limbs. So that's, we can't really carry things around. Is that where we're going? Up there? To the ice peak? Looks like we still have a while ways to go. More triangles.
This king was master of all he surveyed, he went on. He gathered to himself all the riches and fine things of the world. His every desire was met, but still he wanted more. Possessed with accumulation, he neglected his kingdom, even his wife and only son. The more he gained, the more he wanted. He piled up all his treasure in a great storeroom and locked it away. But one day, his young son found the key and entered the chamber.
And then what happened? I'm sure you'll tell us in approximately 2 minutes. Where's the path? Where was I going? It was headed this way, right? Yeah, I think. Oh, wow. Alright, now you can tell us what you found. We're going back into a cave? You're gonna slow us down again, aren't you? Into the cave of crystal. Actually, no, it looks like it comes back out again. It's just like a little protective arch. Oh, the rain sounds have gone away.
The king heard a loud crash and ran to the treasure room. There he saw a great avalanche of gold falling on his son and crushing him. Try as he could not pull the boy from the heavy flood. He dug and dug in the gold, but his son was lost. Too late did he feel the love he had for his only son. In the collecting of things, he ignored the only thing that really did matter.
Well, maybe if he had collected things and not been hoarding the gold, it would have turned out better. What if he used the gold to buy a lifetime supply of balsa wood that would not have crushed the boy? But yet he would still be collecting things, wouldn't he? I have the Q on now for the auto run. I'm getting tired of holding that down.
The king was consumed with grief and vowed to never possess another thing that he didn't need. He gave away all his treasure to the poor people of the kingdom and set out alone to live a life free of possessions. Was this mad fisher once a king? I found it very doubtful. You see, Lula, he said, we often learn too late what is really important in life. There is an old saying that the owl of wisdom only spreads its wings at twilight.
Meaning what? You learn wisdom later in life, I guess. He could be a king. Doesn't want you to know about it.
What does it mean? I asked. He replied, it means that we only learn the valuable lessons when it is too late. We only decide to change when we are forced into it, with our backs against a wall. We can change at any time if we choose to, but we usually don't until it becomes necessary. In any event, there is always hope. And with that, I heard the sudden rumble of thunder as dark clouds suddenly gathered in the sky, and it began to rain.
Yeah, I hear the rumble of thunder myself. And someone's going like crazy on some pipes or something as well. I also hear that. So now we're going up again? This drizzle path is longer.
The fisher turned his face up to the sky and smiled into the rain. At last, he turned to me with his wild but knowing eye and said, seek the middle way, Lula. Between all and nothing, find the middle way. But know that you will not find it out in the world. It is in a secret place that only you can find. And the greatest secret of all is that there is no secret. You will find the genie, and when you do, you will understand even the dreaming gods.
Well, there was no middle way. Wait a second. Not this way. There was no middle way. There was the red stuff and the blue stuff. That's all we had. Whee!
Oh, I have to jump across.
Wait. Turn off the queue. That would not do to be... have the queue on now. Oh, there's more of those things down there. I think maybe that's a save point or something? Decaying save points. Jump! Auto run.
Then I knew he was truly mad. It made no sense. A secret that there is no secret. But he spoke to me of the genie long before my dream, where the wizard told me to find it. Was it a dream? I can't remember. For all I know, it was real, and I am dreaming now. Are we all asleep and dreaming the world? Are the gods real? It is all beginning to confuse me very much. I can only hope that he was right about the genie.
You have a lot of questions. Oh, there's the volcano again. The Red Mountain.
I should much like to reach the mountain before winter falls. I wonder if my mother came this way. Did she brave the storms and lean into the wind, pressing on? Turning back never seems an option, I know. Having come this far myself. Sometimes in the wind, I think I can hear you singing to me. You sing the rains. You sing the snows to me.
Oh.
It makes me brave against the elements.
Oh, she abandoned you, though. Why are you going to be happy about her singing to you? It'll be a song of betrayal and loss. I like to make those high jumps and see how I take no damage whatsoever. I don't expect that there would be damage, but... ooh, sparkly. It's just in most games you would. You would go crack and... you would go, ah, or something. You're like, 8 points of health.
How my mind has frozen on you, on a soul beautiful as first frost. I am snowblind, mad without footprints.
That's unfortunate.
Your coronal pallor, contoured and torpid as an angel's trumpet. I close my eyes and imagine you alone in a forest chapel, watching the snows fall on midwinter's eve. You see me through the window, standing alone in the dark pines, storm-torn and buffeted by the winds. You see me and slowly draw the curtains.
Right, but she's outside, isn't she? How does she draw the curtains if she's outside? I like the lightning flashes. More red stuff.
I lean into the cold and think of the pale promise locked in winter. Though it is the dying of summer, the quietly encroaching cold hiding in leaves. It holds the expectancy of spring. A diminuendo of green sadly passes, but will keep warm the winter long and clutch the memory of warmth in our hearts. Though spring promises nothing of herself in returns, and summer swears no shrift of conscience in its leave-taking, we sing.
We sing. I wanted to stop to look at that word. I'm not familiar with that word, diminuendo. Sounds like a diminished innuendo. Like it's a small amount of innuendo. Ah. No. must not become stuck on terrain. We've come too far for that. So, yeah, like in the first Drizzlepath, rain becomes snow.
We may come to regret that we rued the florid heat of summer, even as it slips always away again. We may yet sing of birth and rebirth as the new grass lights the air and meadow birds sing with us. Winter groans in sheets of ice and burdens of snow, but in that voice we hear the promise of spring. With mittened hands cupped against the cold, we sing of life and light again the candles of hope.
The candles of hope. Another bridge. This one, a thick one. We got more stuff over there. I'm not going to bother with that. The red stuff. I don't know what it means.
Actually, not much left, I guess.
Cool, not much left. I actually like the color blue a lot more than red, but if I decided to do the eeny, meeny, miny route, and thus we had done so. Oh, there's something there. Is that a statue, or is that a thing that moves? And oh, there's a few of them.
There are those who simply never choose a path. They know that neither extreme is balanced, that they cannot find the middle path, and so they become frozen in a stasis of indecision.
Huh.
Distracted by anything and following the whims of the day, they seek to fill the emptiness with any passing fancy. They too seek the genie, but they do not know why, and so become lost. Even with unmoving eyes, they see me. They would eat me alive if they could.
That one has... Yeah, I don't like that very much, the thing had glowing eyes. Oh, that's a dragon. Oh, okay, maybe we just go. Don't stop. Okay. It's just, wait, I got the cue on. Okay. So I had the hackles raised up a little bit. I have no idea if I had stopped, the thing would attack.
I often think of my very first memory as a child. It was the spring thaw, when the blankets of snow began to melt, the sun shined its warmth, and the birds began to sing again. In my mother's frozen garden was a stone that had cracked, buckled by the cold.
Hello?
And there in the crack was a single, tiny white flower, a bloom of only 4 petals. It bravely opened to face the world and greet the sun, as if in defiance of death itself.
Hello, blue-haired lady. I wasn't expecting to see anyone just, like, standing in there. She's supposed to be yawning. Dead ash, though. It's just saying. Alright. The queue is on. The auto run has been enabled once again. Oh, what? We could have gone two ways, I guess. Okay, I guess we'll go this way, though. I don't think I ever noticed there was another path. Hopefully I'm headed the right way.
I knelt by the little snow flower and wondered at it. Here was life in the midst of frozen nothingness.
There's a lot of life here.
It seemed precarious, tender, so unlikely in its setting. But there must be some hidden strength in it to have emerged here, overcoming the elements and the odds. It seems a fortunate incident of nature. Like life itself, perhaps not magical, but wonderful that it has occurred.
Yes. Not magical, just wonderful. I'm wondering if the red triangles are like checkpoints, like if something would kill us. Is that dragon again? I'm just gonna watch it for a little bit. Maybe we should be in sneak mode. No idea if that dragon really poses a threat to us.
Even at that age, the flower made me ponder the teachings of the shamans. They told of how the world is dreamed up by the sleeping gods, and that when we die, we will join them in their dream of paradise and live forever. But I have seen birth and death, and know that they are different. I witness the workings of the world and think it natural, not the magical dreaming of imaginary gods.
Okay. We got sparkly rocks. We want to be going up there. She says there wasn't much left, and that was like 15 minutes ago. Some of that. She lied. Well, simply what she thinks is not much left is really it is. To other people, there'd be quite a lot left.
I cannot tell my thoughts to anyone. They would think me blasphemous, or even mad, to question the shamans.
Mad.
They would think I had lost sight of the truth, of the mysterious, magical workings of life itself. They would think me irreverent, at the very least. But it is not so. Considering the triumph of the tiny flower in the midst of a frozen garden, I have a profound reverence for the unlikely presence of life.
I tried to take a shortcut. It didn't work. Well, better to be thought of as irreverent than irrelevant. That's what I was saying. Actually, no, I never said that until now. Definitely looks a lot faster when you're in smaller spaces like this. Oh. Did sound suspenseful for a moment. Oh, brother.
To say that life is simply magic is, to me, of less value than if it developed as an inevitability in the infinite spans of time and gained a foothold enough to thrive against all the odds. Life is a champion of chance. There is more awe and wonder in this truth than to simply dismiss it as the providence of some great and mystical unknowable. It is made all the more special by its unlikelihood.
Is the dragon friend or foe? Oh! No, you slowed me down again. Nope. Oh. I must fall backwards. That's really slowing down. Going so slow, you went backwards. Oh, hello. Is that the genie? Or just another statue? That is a very big statue. Oh wait, is this more lines? I heard that. Used to make funny sounds while we were lying on the carpet. Yep, more lines from the first. That way. For no reason would his love end by the line drawn by a certain death. You have to keep on climbing up the mountain of fire despite all the lies and curses. I was wondering what she's saying too, and now we can see it. There will be no more witchery curses around the neighborhood for 4 years. This is the reason why she will still burn in your love until the end of time. Say no more. Just say no more. I do remember that part. I miss the old melodies, especially the one that opened our journey. Play it, and I remain silent. She doesn't remain silent for long. That's alright, though. Okay, before the dragon comes back on its patrol, I don't know if I need to worry about the dragon. But, keep an eye on it just the same. I'm not seeing it right now. Yeah, I can't go faster anymore. How sad. How dare you give this power to me and then take it away? You fiend. Okay. Oh, I'm supposed to go this way, okay. I don't know why I keep thinking about EverQuest. This reminds me of those little areas near the zones where you would zone in. It would basically make it super linear for that section, and then boop, zone line, all of a sudden you would be stuck. Loading, please wait. About 30 seconds or so. Oh, wow, you see it there. The Great Rindlesnatch is there. Wow, you really see those clouds moving fast. There's some more red triangles of doom. Is this... That's... We're not supposed to be going that way? Oh, up this way. Yeah. The wind is really picking up over here.
Maybe I'll just step on the air.
Let's find out. Yes.
There we go.
That's an interesting power. Could have done this in the first place just to get to the top of the mountain. Back here, mister.
Between twin expanses of endless nothing, here, for a brief and shining moment, is something rare and beautiful life.
What, that?
It sings in me, and I know that I am. joy fills my heart, and I know that I will never squander a moment of life, however long or brief it may be. We live, we laugh, we learn and grow old. We love and we die. Between birth and death, we have this one chance to just let it be beautiful.
I suppose. Oh, there you go. So I'm beginning to think we have nothing to fear from the dragon. At least, not at the moment. And just like that, it's gone. Breaks my heart every time.
The sky itself cracks open and falls to the ground, the world trembling with change.
That was not the sky.
I have no fear. I feel that soon my path will end, and I know not what I will find. But I have had this time, this one chance to truly be alive. I have lived and loved. Along with heartache and loss, I have known beauty and joy. Even if the end is upon me, I consider how fortunate I've been to have this one brief, shining moment. I have lived, and that is more than enough.
Well, you're only 18 years old. You haven't really lived yet. Kidding me? Are we going up there? Is that what? Eventually?
I found no answers along the path. Only more questions. What is the genie? What does it do? Who made it? And where is it from? I shall soon find out. Perhaps it will answer all my questions. I have considered that it may pose more questions than answers, and feel that somehow I already know the answers. And now I see.
Well, we reach the genie, and it just disembowels us, the end. Oh, we're heading up there. I don't know. I think we are, because we're going this way. So I saw a figure up here, though. Did I not see a figure up here? There's people! People! I think he froze to death. She's alright, though. Is that supposed to be our character? What are you looking for? That's cool. I'm pretty happy. Ooh! One over here. There's more lines from the first Drizzlepath, I guess? I can't really get to it. And so our journey ends here. It is about time to wake your... I want to get closer. Is that... Oh, no. It's about time to wake your... Oh, your friends up. We can't zoom in, only out. Your Apache? Is that... I think she said Apache. And celebrate the second chance you have just been given. To look around you and find the door to a higher walking experience in real life. I remember that. I think she did say Apache friends. That's spelled differently though. Doesn't it look like Apache? Making your A-P-A-C-I with the little thing under the C. There's more figures up here to look at. Oh, there's the dragon! Just in the nick of time. Oh, now we have... Is that the blue and the red? Oh, those look more like turquoise. Oh, hello. Genie, I presume? Who's to the other
that
side?
That must be the genie. Solid, inanimate, but somehow organic. And there, next to it, stands the wizard that spoke to me in my dreams.
That's what I saw.
As I draw nearer, I can hear his voice again. That strange sound, with unmoving lips, that I can understand as words. Lula, he said, you have made it to the Mountain of Fire, and now stand before the genie. You have chosen to face your fears along the shortest path. In facing the darkness of your mind, you have conquered yourself. You have learned that the answers to your questions are within you. You have learned hope. The path you have chosen is the shortest path, and so you are victorious.
The shortest
your
path.
Arrival precedes that of the other wizard who sought to curse you. Still, he wanders the other path, having chosen what he thought was the easiest way. Now, you may lay your hand on the genie, and the program will continue.
The program?
Program? I asked. I don't understand. What is the genie? The genie, he began, is a computational construct.
Oh.
What we call a processor.
Intel inside.
As an operating administrator, I have introduced a packet of data into the genie. It arranges the data into information that runs a program. This program is called Lula. Your first moment of being was just before you chose the path.
What? But I'm 18 years old.
You see, Lula, he continued, this world and everything in it, all your memories and dreams, your mother, your father, and Rofesso have been created by you. You have arranged the data into a stream of consciousness that will not become real until you lay your hand on the genie and verify the information. You will return to your village where your mother and father happily await you. The program will be set and will continue to run indefinitely.
But her mother left.
Your people will be free to choose their own paths in life. You will forget that you began as a program. You will be free to run anywhere you like, to live the life you choose and grow old. Free to laugh and learn, and perhaps most importantly, you will be free to love. What about the other wizard, I wondered. Once you verify, he replied, the bug in the system that you think of as the other wizard will be deleted. Thank you for this learning experience.
Huh.
How could I choose otherwise? I slowly reached out my hand and laid it on the genie. It felt warm, humming with life. I see the world I have created as it becomes real. I feel myself forgetting that it started as a program. What does it matter? I will be with my mother and father again. We will be free and happy. And now I have a story to tell. Was it a dream or a memory? I do not know, but let it begin. Once upon a time?
Huh. She's a computer program. But even as a computer program, she created stuff. But doesn't become real until she touches the genie. But who's the girl with the blue hair? And the guy that was just sitting there. Original game genie sculpture. Well, that was interesting. You know, I want to go back and check the other path. I would normally end here, but she keeps saying the other path was different. Longer, unfortunately. But if we took the other path, we would not have beaten the evil wizard. So the evil wizard, which was a bug in the program, which was then deleted, used Unreal Market Access. Yeah, he went from CryEngine to Unreal Engine 4 with this one. You're welcome for playing. But Yeah. Did you try the other path? No, we did not. It is different. Okay. Alright, I'm definitely gonna try it out. I don't like that's longer, though. Last checkpoint. Alright. So we don't want last checkpoint. I just want to see where it puts us. Probably right before the ending cinematic, I guess.
Once upon a time. Isn't that how stories are supposed to begin? That is how my mother always began her stories.
Right, so I'm gonna get back to the...
Last night in my dreams.
We saw this stuff before. I'm gonna get back to where the fork in the road is, and I'll speed all this up, and we'll resume to where taking the blue path, and then see where that goes. So I will... hitting the mic. I'll see you guys there.
A mysterious wizard came to me.
Okay, here we are at the crossroads, the red and the blue. We're gonna take... the blue now.